But what they did is they put rules also upon the blood sport named rat killing in the rat pits. And what they did is they measured how many, so not if a dog could kill rats, as some people think, but how many rats a dog would be able to kill within a limited time frame. And that meant that, of course, you had to have quick dogs, but they also had another rule. They divided the amount of rats killed in the time frame by the weight of the dog. So also, it gave another instinct. They're not only able to kill rats, also do it quickly, but also be very light. So you were breeding for that purpose. Dogs that were as small as possible, light as possible, but still able to quickly dispatch of rats. And that sometimes were pure bulldogs. Some bulldogs were in the 10 kilogram. They were quite rare. And also other dogs were used. So some bulldogs are even noted to be below 5 kilogram. But there are other types of dogs that were very small, and that were the terriers. Why were they small? Because terrier contains the name or the word terra. Terra means earth. So there were dogs that were able to go into the burrows to follow, for example, foxes or badgers, which are also pests to the farmers now and then, of course. And they wanted to have a canine gladiator below ground that was able to handle them. Some were more of the barking type, but they also had more of the gladiator type of terriers. For example, the Pattedale type, or the Fell terriers before them, or before them even the Black and Tan terriers, were more of the competitive type. And also a small type of pit dog was, for example, the Northumberland terrier, which has the name terrier but was more of a pit dog. And as a result, both of those canine gladiator families, the bulldogs, more of a molosser type, and also the terriers, also a gladiator type but more for hunting purposes, collided. So they sometimes were matched against each other in a rat pitting contest, but sometimes also in a dog fighting contest. And that gave rise to some terrier blood in the makeup of the American Pit Bull Terrier, and also the name Bull Terrier that its ancestor had. So they called the Bull Terriers, and sometimes also half and half. So they had blood of both strains or families running through their veins. And those dogs lay the foundation for the Boer Terrier of the past. Very few such a Boer Terrier. Oi oi! But also for for example, we find them much closer to the genes of the molosses. Closer than the English molosses, I have to say, even closer than the English bulldog, because the English bulldog came from the molosses, but also has a little bit of pet genes. Running to its veins, like the pug. Just make it more exaggerated features instead of functional. So, long story short, American Pit Bull Terrier is the most pure incarnation of the old working bulldog as found in England. And I think even more so than the modern day American Bulldogs, which also some are still being used as a working dog, because I think those American working bulldogs, especially the Scott type, Johnson type, has such a flat head again. It's a lot faster, and this has genes of the American Triple Terrier, but also some other genes used in them. I think some bulldog blood, but especially also other more running type of faster, like Alano or others. So those are more of the Spanish type of molossus intertwined. Another take on the bulldog, but a little bit heavier and more of a molossus type. Nou, blijf elkaar weer tegenkomen, hè.